too far into things, I do have to thank this video's sponsor. Yes, that's right, my very first sponsor. Vikings War of the Clans is a game that you can play for your mobile devices completely free that is directly inspired by the top RPG and strategy games of the 90s, like Age of Empires or The Settlers. Games that completely killed any kind of social experiences I had in middle school. If you want to relive these memories again and experience something completely new, then this mobile game with amazing graphics is exactly what you've needed. Vikings gives you the option to choose your own playstyle, which is incredibly important to somebody like me, and what makes it so freaking addictive is the fact that it has over 20 million players and growing, which means there's always somebody to fight and always an alliance to make as you capture your own resources and build your clan up into the very best it could possibly be. The never-ending war for resources is constantly changing as well, with in-game updates and new live events. So, support my channel by clicking on the links down in the description box below, and not only will you support my channel, but you'd also get yourself 200 free gold and a protective shield, and you would be helping the channel. So everybody wins. Now into some tanks. What I'm holding in my hand right here is an exceptionally exciting find. This was sent to me by Buffdaddy Nerf. And no, I wasn't just sent one. I was sent 12. That should probably clue you in on not only how inexpensive these things are, but everything you think this is, it actually is. Unless you think it's something absolutely insane. And arguably, I would say it is something that's absolutely insane, but this is a remote-controlled, for all intents and purposes, jolt that on wheels that fires remotely. I don't know what else I have to say besides that. It's a jolt, but it's on wheels, and you can use a remote to fire it. That is really exciting, especially for the fact that it only costs you $5. If you're a kid and you want something really cool and fun to play with, here you are. This'll definitely get you $5 worth. If you're a modder, the possibilities are really, really crazy. But let's assume for a second that you have no idea what kind of implications this make, and allow me to educate you, because this is something I'm really excited about. So for one, the cost. It's $5 to buy one of these things. Two, this is what you get. You get the dart blaster tank thing itself with two dart holders that are removable. In fact, you could basically steal them out of the package if you wanted to. That's not a great design, but whatever. Four darts located back there, and the remote control, which already has batteries in it, but for those of you that care, it takes three LR44 batteries, and the tank itself requires three AAA batteries. And apparently the remote is, I assumed it's radio control. They'll say 27 megahertz right here, but I mean, it needs line of sight and everything like that, so yeah, the range is kind of iffy. It works fine for, like, you know, house battles and stuff like that. Outside, not so much. It does work, I'll give it that. And then, of course, the button down here actually fires the blaster, and that is perhaps the most interesting thing. Yes, this is a Springer-powered blaster that has a remote trigger. So right there, things are already starting to get a little spicy. So let's take a look at this one right here. This one is really telling, because, I won't lie, the quality control on this $5 tank is not great. Some of them, the air restrictors are so heavily glued down that I basically had to destroy the dart in order to get it in there to function properly. This one is the most hilarious. Of the seven I have opened, this one, the on-off switch doesn't do anything. If it's off, it still runs. Here it is. Oh, look. Yeah, that's awesome. And then I turn that on and Yep, it still works, which is kind of annoying. I think this one I'll have to actually take the batteries out every single time I'm done using it, or the batteries are going to die in it. So that's a little annoying, but for $5, I wouldn't really be that upset because it's so freaking cheap and it does something that we really don't have another version of. I mean, we do have a couple of things. There's of course the Terra Scout, the Terra Drone, the Attack Nids, those kind of walking or rolling blaster robot things, but those cost a lot of money. There is, of course, the rival version, a big robot thing. That's like $100. It shoots rival rounds. It's pretty cool. And there's a couple of other things out there that do these kinds of things, but there's really nothing this cheap and works this well. So even if you take the blaster, like just a fun value, I mean, frickin', it's a tank for $5. It does not reverse. The control here, while it looks like it has a joystick, it's really just two micro switches. One of them pushes the tank forward, the other one makes it spin clockwise. So that's how you turn it. Not perfect, but whatever. And as you can see, the movement speed is not that bad at all, but the most important thing about these is the fact they fire darts. So I have a bright green Adventure Force dart in here. I cock that back like a jolt or something that fires, like a glow shot or something like that. And now I can move it around, but most importantly is I can press the button down here on the remote and it fires a dart. That's basically all I would ever have to show you to say this thing is 100% worth your money. But let's go a little bit deeper. I'm a modder. I have a variety of skills when it comes to dabbling with toy blasters, and well, right off the bat, this thing could probably do with a heavier spring upgrade. It is basically, I'm trying to think of like the really low-end Zuru X-Shot blaster that this clearly is. It's basically one of those, but of course it's direct prime, it is a direct plunger, so obviously that could probably take some kind of spring upgrade. The biggest thing against this would be the fact that there's actually a motor and gear system in here that turns around that will basically move and depress the catch. That's pretty cool in and of itself, but that does limit the kind of pressure you can put on the catch and of course what pressure it can take in the spring load. But let's say for a second that that could possibly take a lot of pressure. Well, there's almost nothing stopping you from putting any other blaster on the top of this thing that works basically like a night finder, but basically has a catch that can be pushed up to release a plunger rod through a plunger tube and direct air power to a dart. There's almost nothing preventing you from doing that, which is pretty friggin' cool. Honestly, that's amazing to me. For $5, powered off AAAs, that kind of remote functionality cannot be ignored. But it gets a little bit better, because when you think about this thing in the grand scheme of electronics, and this is coming from somebody who is a self-admitted total idiot, this gets a little bit spicier, because there's nothing stopping you from completely removing the RC functionality out of this in terms of it being a drivable vehicle. Of course, when I press one of these switches, it's going to direct power to these wheels right here. The little tank treads on the side are completely fake. They don't do anything. It's actually driven by these tiny little wheels down here. Let's say I wanted to run this with anything that has an electronic trigger, like say a rapid strike. Well, it wouldn't be hard for me to rewire the things that have to do with the power going to the motors that drives the wheel to say the rev trigger on a rapid strike. And then of course a button right there that would go to the full auto trigger on a rapid strike. You'd most likely need a MOSFET in between those, but we're talking pennies on the dollar here to get this thing doing some pretty insane stuff. And then you would have a kind of, not kind of, you would have a tiny rapid strike blaster that you could stuff somewhere and remote control. What more do I have to say to get people excited for this thing? The main problem with these is that apparently they're only available at $5 below, and there's not one of those anywhere near me. I had to get these shipped to me from Buffdaddy, and there's no telling if these things won't show up in other places, other similar stores. These are made by Playtech Fun Stuff, but $5 remote control tank. Who cares if it, you know, doesn't, the air restrictors need some work. Who cares if it doesn't necessarily always drive straight? It doesn't work that well outside, and it sure as heck isn't going to work in gravel or grass or anything like that, but the applications of a blaster like this are insane to me. This is something that everybody should be really excited for, and even if you're not that big into electronics, it's really easy to figure this kind of stuff out, and I'm saying that being somebody who's no better than you. In fact, most likely I'm worse than you, but I can understand, like, oh, here's two wires that go to a motor from this board. If I take those two wires or take that motor and put it to something else, the power is going to be the same. Now, obviously, if I have the blaster controlled by, let's say, a 3S LiPo, I'm clearly going to need some kind of MOSFET to act as an electronic trigger to prevent backflow of any kind of energy into this thing and blowing it up. But just the idea of a very cheap radio-controlled application that will allow me to do whatever the heck I want. And seriously, the applications can be nearly limitless. I mean, there is no reason why you couldn't work the actual trigger mechanism into an XBZ. Seriously, like, you would still have to either put some kind of compressor or pump it up manually yourself. And yes, I do understand that some of the excitement is lost by the fact that once this thing fires, I will have to drive it back to me, prime it, and load another dart into it. But these things are light, and you can clip them, use them pretty much anywhere on your person, set it down. One remote will work with potentially infinite number of these things. You get the idea. That wasn't pretty because there's just not enough space here, but you can see what I'm getting at. You basically have your own Nerf army. I can create my own Nerf firing squad for the price of, like, a scavenger. This is pretty nutso to me. It has a flip-up sight right here. Who cares? I hate to say it. The dart holders come off if you don't want to have the cool little drone with it looks like little missiles on the side of them. It's just, it's amazing to me. This has blown my mind so much. You can make these wearable. You can have them as easy to do shoulder cannons. There's so much you can do with a little tiny RC tank like this that I expect these things to sell out pretty much immediately after this video. And I'm sorry for that. I really am. I've got more than enough for me to play around with. Again, I was sent like 12 of them, but seriously, this is something you're gonna wanna pick up before they disappear. Hopefully, more of these kinds of things get made. Hopefully, it's not a Gen 1 Panther or something like that where it becomes increasingly impossible to get your hands on one. And I do say that since these things have such kind of a really bad quality control, I would probably pick up more than one just to be safe that you'll have a completely working one. I haven't opened the other five I have, but it's safe to assume that in 12 of them, chances are one of these won't work at all. There is two colors of these things, so if you want to have like RC tank battles, the blue ones I believe run off like 49 megahertz right there it says, and the red ones are off 27 megahertz, so yeah, there's a lot to love here, even from anything from a kitchen battle, or if your entire house is linoleum, definitely use it for that, all the way up to some high-end modding applications. These things are incredible, and I very hope anybody watching these videos can pick these things up. If somebody finds them online, can post it down below, that would be great. These are amazing. For $5, they're an absolute friggin' steal. I can't believe this is a video I get to make, and it's all thanks to Buffdaddy. He made this dream come true, and I cannot thank him enough. I will put links down below to Blaster Hub, because Buffdaddy is one of the major contributors to Blaster Hub, and of course his own blog down there, and anything else if he comes up and wants me to do a video on, that's fine, perfectly fine, because he deserves it. This could never happen, and yet here it is. Not only was this thing found, but I get to be a part of it, and I have so many ideas for these, I don't even know where to begin. And of course, if you have any crazy ideas, I'd love to hear them down below. There's only so much these things can do, but still, the applications involved are pretty insane.
There's no reason why these can't do a lot of different things for a lot of different kinds of blasters. And it really opens the door to, like, it's not gonna be that hard for you to amp up the motors and stuff like that and make them even stronger. Maybe you can make it press tougher catches and stuff like that. I'm really excited to see what comes out of these, and I'm really excited to get my chance to play with them myself because these are way too cool. Let me know what you think about the Combat RC Tank. If XB is really the only thing we have about it. The XB Combat RC Tank down in the comment section below. Because this is so cool. This is, and I know this is one of those videos where I just kind of frothed at the mouth a little bit, but this is one of the most exciting things that has happened in a very long time to this hobby. Super cheap, entry level applications for a wide variety of high-end projects. It's gonna be a blast, quite literally. I'm Walcom S7, thank you so much for watching this video. Of course, if you want to talk more about these kinds of things, there's a link to my Discord channel down in the description below. And also, I'm sure you've noticed this little join button next to the beautiful subscribe button. That is so you can become a member of my channel. And the cool thing about that is it costs you $5 a month, but there's a couple of great perks that happen, and the perks are gonna change over time. But right now, when you join, you get a little dart next to your name whenever you comment on a video, which means your comment is going to stand out. And the longer you are a member, that dart will evolve from a simple elite dart to a mega dart, all the way up to a 1995 crossbow arrow. If you're a big fan of the channel and you interact with me at a bunch of different places, that can be yours for $5 a month, and it really helps my channel, and of course, the sponsorships like I had from Vikings, War of the Clans. Hopefully I get more chances to do stuff like that, because that is a big deal that's really going to make these upcoming projects a lot easier on me. I just finished buying all the pieces for the build paradigm shift, and things are about to get really exciting. But I drag on, thank you very much, and of course, I hope to see you in an entirely different video.
You gotta